talk to, approachable, mostly just be yourself. That's okay, that's number one. Yourself.
Be true, my God.
Also, don't worry about whether your hands are going to get sweaty for no reason and you can't make it stop no matter what you do because they're not going to get sweaty. So, and don't worry, even bringing it up, it's not going to happen because you're just, all you have to do is just be yourself. You're not even going to worry about it though, seriously, it's not going to be like that time you had the perfect chance to introduce yourself to Zoe Murphy at the jazz band concert last year, when you waited afterward to talk to her and tell her how good she was, and you were going to pretend to be super casual, like you didn't even know her name, she would introduce herself, and you'd be like, wait, I'm sorry, Chloe? You said your name was Chloe? And she'd be like, no, it's Zoe, I said Zoe. You'd be like, oh, see, I thought you said Chloe, because I'm very busy with other stuff right now. But then you didn't even end up saying anything to her anyway, because you were scared, your hands were sweaty, because they weren't that sweaty, so you started wondering if they were sweaty, which made them sweaty. So you put them under the hand dryer in the bathroom, but then they were still sweaty. They were just very warm now as well.
So you just decided not to eat last night?
Oh, my mom, I wasn't hungry.
You're a senior in high school, Evan. You need to be able to order dinner for yourself while at work. You can do it all online now. You don't have to talk to anyone on the phone. I know you don't like it.
Okay, you see, that's not true. Actually, you have to walk the door and first meet the door. You know, you're going to change the style of the side of your
house. This is what you're supposed to be working on, Evan, with Dr. Sherman. Talking to people, engaging with people, not running away from people.
You're right. I'm going to be a lot better.
Oh, no, I know. I know you are. And that's why I made an appointment with Dr. Sherman for this afternoon. I'll pick you up right after school.
I already have an appointment next week.
And I thought maybe you could use something a little sooner. Have you been writing those letters he wants you to do? The letters to yourself? The pep talks? Dear Evan Hansen, this is going to be a good day. Here's why. Have you been doing those?
I started writing one. Finished it at school.
Those letters are important, honey. They're going to help you build your confidence. Seize the day!
I guess.
I don't want my dear to be sitting at home on your computer every Friday night telling me you have no friends.
Neither do I.
Can we try to have an optimistic outlook? Huh? Can we look up just enough to see the world won't fall apart? Maybe this year we decide we're not giving up before we've tried this.
Bye.
friends. Well, acquaintances more like.
Well, do you want to maybe? I don't know what you're on. Do you want to tell me my past?
Oh my god, what happened to your arm?
Oh, well, I broke it. I was climbing a tree.
Oh, really? My grandma broke it getting into the bathtub in July. That was the beginning of the end, the doctor said. Because then she died. Happy first day!
Is it weird to be the first person in history to break their arm from jerking off too much? Do you consider that an anomaly?
But I didn't. I wasn't doing that.
Take me the picture. You're in your bedroom, you've got Zoe Murphy's Instagram up on your weird off-brand cell phone.
That's what happened, obviously. I was climbing a tree and I fell.
You fell out of a tree? What are you, like, an acorn?
Well, I don't know if you know this, but I worked this summer as an apprentice park ranger at Ellison State Park. I'm sort of a tree expert now. Not to brag. But anyway, I tried to climb this 40-foot-tall oak tree.
And then you fell.
Well, except it's a funny story because it was a solid 10 minutes after I fell, and I just lay there on the ground, waiting for someone to come get me. Any second now! I kept saying to myself, any second now! Here they come!
And did they?
No, nobody came. That's what's funny.
Jesus Christ.
What did you do for them? I'm sorry, you had midsummer?
Well, my bunk dominated and captured the flag, and I got to second base below the bra with this girl from Israel who's like, gonna be in the army, so... yeah. Hopefully that answers your question.
What's on my cast?
Why are you asking me?
Well, just... I thought, because we're friends.
Whoa, we're family friends. That's like a whole different thing, and you know it. Hey, tell your mom to tell my mom that I was nice to you, or else my parents won't make my car insurance.
I will.
Oh, hey, Connor! Loving the new hair length. Very school shooter chic. I was kidding. It was a joke?
Yeah, no, it was funny. I'm laughing. Can you tell? Am I not laughing hard enough for you?
You're such a freak.
What the fuck are you laughing at?
What?
Stop fucking laughing at me!
I'm not.
You think I'm a freak?
No,
I'm not the freak!
What?
You're the fucking freak!
Tell Oh, great.
Captain Hansen, that's your name, right?
That's just as stupid. It's a paper, I had to write to this, isn't it?
Because they're Sony. Wait, is this about my sister?
No, not at all.
You wrote this so that I would find it.
What?
Well, you saw that I was the only person in the computer lab, so you wrote this and you printed it out so that I would find it.
Why would I do that?
So I would read some creepy shit you wrote about my sister and freak out, right? You can tell everyone I'm crazy, right?
No, wait, I don't need one! But I really, I need that back! Please, can you just give me, please, give it back?
A letter to yourself? What the crap does that even mean? Like some sort of sex thing?
It's not a sex thing. It was an assignment.
Why are you talking to me about this?
I didn't know who else to talk to. You're my only family friend.
Oh my god.
I don't know what to do. He stole a letter from me 3 days ago, and then he hasn't been in school since.
Oh, that does not bode well for you.
What's he going to do with it?
Who knows? Connor Murphy is batshit out of his mind. Do you remember when he threw a printer at Mrs. G in second grade? Because he didn't get to be a line leader that day?
Do you think he's going to show the letter to other people?
He's going to ruin your life with it, for sure. I mean, I would. Yourself.
Isn't that only when you're under oath, like in a courtroom?
Well, Weren't you under oath, in a way?
No!
Yeah, he was definitely in my English class.
Look, do you want to listen to me, or do you want to have another meltdown? Like last year in English, when you were supposed to give that speech about Daisy Buchanan, but instead you just stood there, staring at your note card, saying, over and over again, like you were having a brain aneurysm.
What do you expect me to do? Just keep lying?
I didn't say lie, just... All you have to do is just nod and confirm. Whatever they say about Connor, you just nod your head and say, yeah, that's true. Don't contradict and don't make shit up. It's foolproof. Literally, nothing I tell my parents is true, and they have no idea.
3 days ago, Connor Murphy was here, and now? And now he's gone.
They were so sad. His parents? His mom was just... I've never seen anyone so sad before.
Well, good thing you're about to tell the truth about your sex letter. She'll have to share her right.
I can't believe you took me there.
grabbing the one who's holding the moon, grabs her hat all along, and they hear it together.
Thank you.
kicked your ass? That's like the exact formula of the secret gay high school lovers. This is what I told you. What did I tell you? You just nod and confirm.
You don't understand. Like, I'm nervous, and I start talking. And once we started,
you just couldn't stop.
They didn't want me to stop.
So what else did you completely fuck up?
Nothing. Seriously. I mean, I told them we were emails.
Emails?
Yeah. I told them Connor, just had this secret email account.
Oh, right! One of those secret email accounts! Sure! For sending pictures of your penises to each other.
Yeah, and so I told them we have this secret account and we would send emails to each other.
I mean, honestly, could you be any worse than this?
They're gonna want to see our emails.
You think?
What am I going to do?
I can do emails. Now, there's a reason why I was the only junior counselor to have the keycard access to the computer bus this summer. I have skills, sir.
You can do that.
$2,000?
$2,000?
$500?
I can give you 20.
Fine, forget.
Here, I have some very exciting news. Went down on my day. College scholarship essay contest. Have you heard of these?
I think so.
I heard a whole thing about it on radio this morning. You know, the ones you can do, I spent my whole lunch break looking these up. The John F. Kennedy Profile and Courage Scholarship, $3,000. Henry David Thoreau Society, $5,000. For all the different charities. College is going to be so great for you guys. How many times would you like to get the chance to just start all over again?
No, I know.
You've got so much, so many wonderful things ahead of you. Now, high school isn't always... Please, the only people that like high school are cheerleaders and football players, and those people all end up miserable anyway. Yeah, you're gonna find yourself in college. I really think so. I mean, I wish I could go with you. I just thought these were... seemed like a good idea.
It is, for sure.
You've always been a wonderful writer, and we're gonna need all the help we can get for college. Unless your stepmother has a trust fund for you I didn't know about? With all those fabulous tips she made, cocktail waitressing? Hey, I got an email from your school today about a boy who killed himself. Connor Murphy. I had no idea.
Yeah, well, I didn't really know him.
You know, if you want to talk about anything, I realize that lately you must feel like I'm always working or I'm in class.
It's funny.
Well, I'm here. And if I'm not here, I'm a phone call away, text, email, whatever.
Thanks.
It says Connor on your...
Oh, yeah, no.
You said you didn't know him.
No, I didn't. This is... It's a different color.
Oh. I've been so worried.
No, I'm sure.
Oh. Hey, you know what? How about I bag my ship next Tuesday? When was the last time we did a Taco Tuesday?
Oh, you don't have to.
No, you've been back at school a week already, and I've barely seen you. Maybe we can start brainstorming those essay questions together.
That would be great.
That's exciting. I'm excited now. Something to look forward to.
Me too.
Are you okay, Mr. Phillips?
Yes.
But don't stay out too late.
It won't.
I love you.
I love you too.
Sucks that we don't talk that much, but I should tell you that I think of you each night. I rub my nipples and start calling with delight.
Why would you write that?
I'm just trying to tell the truth.
You know, you're not going to take this seriously.
Okay, you need to calm yourself.
This needs to be perfect. These emails have to prove that you were actually friends. They have to be completely realistic.
There is nothing unrealistic about about the love one man feels for another.
Let's go back.
In fact, someone said there's something quite beautiful.
Let's go back, Jared.
I gotta tell ya, life without you has been hard. It's been bad. It's been rough. And I was talking about life and other stuff.
Very specific.
Shut up.
I like my parents.
Who says that?
I love my parents, but each day's another fight. I stop smoking drugs, then everything might be alright.
Smoking drugs?
Just fix it.
This isn't realistic at all. It doesn't even sound like Connor.
I'm really sure that I was, like, a good friend, you know? That I was trying to help him.
Oh my god.
If I stop smoking crack.
Crack?
If I stop smoking pop, then everything might be alright. I'll take your advice. Try to be more nice. Turn it around, wait and see. Cause all it takes is a little reinvention. See the change and give it your attention. All you gotta do is just believe you can be who you wanna be. Sincerely.
Are we done yet?
I can't just show them one email.
Okay, please stop hyperventilating. You're having considerable trouble breathing.
I'm having any trouble breathing. Stop doing drugs, just try to take deep breaths and go on walks.
No.
Sending pictures of the most amazing trees.
No.
Obsessed with all my forest expertise.
Absolutely not.
To the crowd of you, just keep pushing through. You're turning around, I can see just what you see. Cause all it takes is a little reinvention. Change and give it your attention. All you gotta do is just believe you can be who you wanna be. Sincerely.
My sister's hot.
What the hell?
Yes, and thanks for every note she sent.
Just...
is behind you. Everything wasted, nothing to say. So I can sing no requiem.
I hear your voice feeling me. In these words I finally find you. Now I know that you are still here.
Tacos another night, and we can do tomorrow night. How about tomorrow night?
I can't tomorrow. I'm busy.
shouldn't wait.
You should go.
No, let's figure this out.
It's fine.
Evan.
I'll make dinner for myself.
You want to say again, don't you?
Very much so, yes.
Weird.
I know.
Why did he say that?
Just see you so far away. And what do you do when this is true? just the losers who keep waiting to be seen.
Right?
I mean, no one seems to care or stops to notice that we're there, so we get lost in the in-between. But if you can somehow keep them thinking of me, and make me more than an abandoned memory, well, that means we matter too. Someone will see that you are there. No one deserves to be forgotten. No one deserves to fade away. No one should come and go and have no one know he was ever even here. No one deserves
for tomorrow. For the assembly. When Connor started seventh grade, all my girlfriends said, here comes bar mitzvah season. He's gonna have a different party every Saturday. I took him to get a suit, some shirts, a tie. He didn't get invited to a single one. I thought you could wear this tomorrow for your speech.
My what?
Well, Alana said anyone who wanted to would have the chance to say something tomorrow. I think we all assumed you'd be the first to sign up.
I don't know. The thing is just, I don't really do very well with public speaking. I'm not very good at it. You wouldn't want me to, trust me.
Of course I want you to. I'm sure the whole school wants to hear from you. I know Larry and I do. And Zoe. Think about it.
You see, the thing is, when I looked up, Connor was there. That was the gift he gave me. He showed me that I wasn't alone. He showed me that I mattered. That everyone does. That was the gift he gave all of us. I wish we could have given that to him. So, not bad alone. When you don't feel strong enough to stand, you can reach out your hand. And oh, someone will come running, and I know I'll take you home. Even when the dark comes crashing through, when you need a friend to carry you, and when you're broken on the ground, you will be found. So let the sun come streaming in, 'cause you'll reach up and you'll rise again. Lift your head and look around, you will be found. My speech?
People started sharing it, I guess, and now, I mean, Connor is
your speech is everywhere. This morning, the car project page, they only have 56 people following.
How many does it have now?
16,239.
I don't understand. What happened?
The world needs to hear this.
A beautiful tool.
Faith, I know someone who really needed to hear this today. So thank you, Evan Hansen, for doing what you're doing.
I never met you, Connor.
But coming up here, being everyone's close, it's so easy to feel alone. But Evan is exactly right. We're not alone. None of us.
None of us.
None of us.
None of us.
None of us are alone.
Oh, especially now.
With everything I'm hearing,
so I will watch you.
Thank you.
everyone. Family. Me.
No, this is...
You've given me my brother back.
Jared's
last night?
Yeah, well, we're doing a Spanish project together.
torture? You told me you broke your arm at work, at the park.
Who do you think drove me to the hospital? Who do you think waited with me in the emergency room for 3 hours? You were a work member. I couldn't even... You did that to your phone!
You told me your boss took you to the hospital!
Well, so I lied, obviously.
When are you planning on telling me any of this? Or your work?
When would I tell you exactly? When are you even here?
I am here right now!
One night a week. Most people, their parents, they turn into a little bit better than that, just so you know.
Isn't that lucky for them?
I have to go to Jared.
No, I don't think I want you going out right now, actually.
I told Jared I'd be at his house 10 minutes
ago. All right, listen! I am missing class tonight, so I couldn't be here to talk to you, Evan. I would like for you to please talk to me.
Okay. I mean, I can't just not do work for school because you decided to miss class. I can't just stop everything whenever you decide it's convenient for you.
I don't understand what's going on with you.
Nothing is going on with me.
You're standing up in front of your school giving speeches. You're president of a group. I don't know who that person is.
You're making a big deal out of something that isn't a big deal.
What is going on with you?
Nothing is going on with me. I'm your mother!
Advice, well, today could be a lucky day for you. the next day you're beat. And you gotta do it for at least a week, every day, consistently. And though this method isn't easy, every second that you spend, it's gonna pay off. It'll pay off in the end. It just takes a little patience. It takes a little time. A little perseverance. And a little uphill climb. You might not think it's worth it. You might begin to doubt. But you can't take any shortcuts. You gotta stick it out. And it's the hard way. But it's the right way. The right way. To break in a glove. Nowadays, with your generation, I hate to say it, but it's all about instant gratification. Who wants to read a book when you can read the Facebook?
Totally.
But with something like this, you have to be ready to put in the work. Make the commitment. What do you think?
I mean, definitely.
Some people say just use a microwave or try that running through hot water technique. Well, they complain about the time they save till they gotta buy another glove next week. It just takes a little patience, takes a little time, a little perseverance, a little uphill climb. It's the hard way, but it's the
shaving cream, rubber bands, mattress, repeat. Got it?
Got it.
It's the hard way,
but it's the right way, the right way
to break in a glove. You're good to go.
Probably 100 of them to actually pay for college when you're out of all tuition, housing, and books.
You're
came over.
Breaking up with you?
God, like, how presumptuous can I get? I didn't even know if we're, like, dating, officially, or whatever, which isn't even... Never mind, why am I even talking right now? Don't worry, it's fine. You can tell me. I'm not gonna cry. Start breaking in.
Breaking up with you.
Thank you.
If you really see me.
been busy.
Busy what?
Just different stuff. How much money do we have left to raise?
Oh, not much. Just $17,000.
I'm sure we'll get there. We just need to, you know, keep people engaged.
Exactly. That's why I'm putting the emails between you and Connor online.
What do you mean?
Mrs. Murphy sent them to me. She said there are a ton more too that you like. Show her a new one every week.
But they're not. Those conversations are really, they're private.
Not anymore. They belong to everyone now. I mean, that's the whole point. The more private they are, the better. That's what people want to see. We have a responsibility to our community to show them everything, to tell them the truth.
Our community?
I'm sending you a list of questions to answer, because some of the emails don't make sense.
What?
Well, like you've been telling everyone that the first time you went to the orchard was the day you broke your arm, but then in other emails, you talk about going there together since last November.
Well, that's because... I mean, those are probably just typos, and it sounds like you're reading into them, like, way too much.
You can explain it all when I send you the questions. You know how much the community loves hearing from you.
Hey! So, my parents are out of town this weekend. The last time we used the liquor cabinet was like Hanukkah, 1997. So we can drink whatever we want.
I can't this weekend. I have $17,000 to raise. Remember, the Connor Project, you're supposed to be working on this.
Remember you told me you didn't need my help?
Well, I didn't tell you to do nothing. I know you think this is all a joke, but it isn't. It's important.
For Connor.
Yeah.
You know, when you really stop and think about it, Connor being dead, that's pretty much the best thing that ever happened to you, isn't it?
That's a horrible thing to say.
Well, no, think about it. If Connor had died, no one would even know who you were. I mean, people at school actually talk to you now. You're almost popular. Which is just... wonder of wonders, miracle of miracles.
I don't care about any of that. I don't care if people at school know who I am. All I wanted was to
help the Murphys!
Hey, Jared. Hi.
Look at you. Helping the Murphys.
What was that?
It's nothing.
Talking about how sneaky you and Connor were.
Something smells good.
Chicken lemonade. I didn't realize we were spending so much time here.
You've been working a lot?
Why did I always think you were Terrence?
I don't know.
Evan, you call and tell your mother that you're staying the night, right?
Of course.
You can rest assured we take very good care of him. He has a toothbrush, so we're not sending him to bed with cavities.
How nice. Evan was showing me all of those scholarship contests that you found. That was really impressive. They're unlike a million. Well, Evan is a great writer.
I don't find that hard to believe at all.
His teacher last year for English said he wrote one of the best papers she'd ever read about Sulu.
It's too long.
And what did I say?
Sulu.
Okay.
Sulu is a character in Star Trek, I believe.
My mistake. Speaking of the scholarships.
I suppose now is as good a time as any, Cynthia.
Zoe happened to mention to us the other day that Evan was having some difficulty in terms of the financial burdens of college. And Larry and I started thinking about it, and we were very fortunate to have been able to set aside some money for our son. I'm okay. I called you this morning to invite you to come join us for dinner tonight, Ivy, because, well, first of all, because we want to thank you for allowing your son to have come into our lives. He was a dear, dear friend to our Connor, and we have just come to love him to pieces. And with your blessing, we would like to give Evan the money we put away for our son, so that he can use it to fulfill his dreams, just like he helped Connor fulfill this.
What do you think?
Wow. That is, I don't know what to say.
It would be such a gift to us if we could do this forever.
It would be a tremendous gift, Tommy. Well, thank you so much. But we're gonna be just fine. I don't have a lot of money, but I do have some.
Oh, no.
No, I understand. It's just, we do have money, so I'm sorry. You were under the impression that we didn't. And whatever money we don't have, Evan will either, he'll get a scholarship, or he'll go to a community college, and that's, I think that's the best thing for us to do. I don't want Evan to get the idea that it's okay to rely on other people for favors.
But it's not a favor.
Well, but as his mother, I need to set that example for him. That you can't expect things from strangers.
Oh, we are not strangers.
No, of course not. Well, thank you for the wine. It was delicious.
Oh, I'm not staying for dinner.
I think I'd better get back to work after all. If I'd have known that Evan was so concerned about our finances, I never would have taken the night off in the first place.
Job is to take care of you.
I'm such a burden. I'm the worst thing that ever happened to you. I ruined your life.
not my fault that other people care.
So we found a place where the grass is greener, and we jumped the fence to the other side. Is it good? Are they giving you a world I could never provide? Well, I hope you're proud of your big decision. Yeah, I hope it's all that you want and more. Now you're free from the agonized boy.
Zoe said she wants me.
Right.
She likes me for who I am.
Except you didn't happen to mention that everything you told her resolved in one big fucking lie, did you? Oh, you left that part out.
So then what if I did tell her the truth?
She'll hate you.
Maybe she would understand. Maybe everyone would understand.
Everyone will hate you.
Not if I could just make it explain, you know?
Go back to where you started. No,
I want
friends,
to be done with this.
Nobody, nothing, alone.
I'm ready to be done with it.
If you really believe that, then why are you standing here talking to yourself? Again? You think you're just going to turn around all of a sudden and start telling everyone the truth? You can't even tell yourself the truth.
What are you talking about?
How did you break your arm? How did you break your arm, Evan?
I fell.
Oh, really? Is that what happened?
Yes! I lost my grip and then I fell!
Did you fall? Or did you let go? You can get rid of me whenever you want. You can get rid of all of it, the Connor Project, the orchard, but then all that you're going to be left with is you. End of May or early June, this picture-perfect afternoon we share. Drive the winding country road, grab a scoop at Alamo, and then we're
I've been a bad co-president. I know that, and I'm sorry, but you were right. You were absolutely right, and I'm back, and I'm rededicating myself to doing everything I can do to make this work.
Too late, I moved on.
You moved on?
You've made it abundantly clear to me that you're not very interested in being part of the Connor Project.
I can make more videos, I can write more stuff for the blog.
I can do all of that myself.
It's not the same, you know it's not the same. People want to hear what I have to say. I wish you the best friend.
You know, frankly, I haven't started to wonder if that's even true.
What do you mean?
You keep saying you're best friends like a broken freaking record about it, but nobody ever saw you together. Nobody even knew that you were friends.
It was a secret. He didn't want
to. I know the story, Evan. We all know the story. We've all heard it a bazillion times.
Seen the emails.
You know how easy it is to create a fake email account? Backdate emails? Because I do. You know what? I don't have time for this. I have to raise $17,000.
Now I can prove it.
How?
Here. If we weren't friends, then why didn't you write your suicide note to me?
Oh my God.
Do you believe me now?
Dear Evan Hansen.
Nobody else has seen this.
Turns out this wasn't an amazing day after all. This isn't going to be an amazing week or an amazing year.
You can't show this to anyone, okay? Nobody else needs to see this.
This is exactly what people need to see. We need something to create new interest.
Can you please delete it now?
Don't you care about building the orchard? This is the best way to make Connor's dream come true.
No, it isn't.
Dear Connor Project community,
you put it online.
Connor's note is a message to all of us. Share it with as many people as you can. Post it everywhere.
You need to take it down.
If you care about someone like Connor, then please consider making a donation to the Connor Murray Memorial Orchard. No amount is too small.
Have people seen this?
Connor Murphy's suicide note.
This is the actual, authentic, and the whole world needs to see this.
Share it with everyone you know.
This is why the orchard is so important.
I just gave $50 for the orchard, and I think everyone else should give as much as they can.
His parents present themselves.
He wrote a suicide note to Evan Hansen because he knew his family didn't give a shit.
His parents, by the way, are insanely rich.
For share.
Like, maybe they should have spent their money on helping their son instead.
Please retweet.
$60 more, and I hold you to be from behind.
Father Murphy,
this is a feeling.
Connor.
took.
Have fun with your miserable life. Bye.
What's the number?
It's blocked. Who cares?
What did they say to you?
Did they threaten you?
Doesn't matter, Dad.
That is it. I am calling the police.
But right now, maybe the best thing to do is to just wait and see if this blows over.
Oh, that's always your solution, isn't it? Do nothing.
Is that what I said?
You guys just stop. Wait and see. Let's wait and see, right, Larry?
What are the police going to do? It's the internet. They're going to arrest the internet?
I had to beg you every step of the way.
Okay, hold on.
I had to leave you for therapy, rehab.
You, who alert you for one miracle cure to the next.
You're really
with all you need is another $20,000, we can never leave.
And what was your alternative other than picking apart everything I did?
Putting him on a program and sticking to it.
No, you wanted to punish him. Listen to your daughter, Larry.
You treated him like a criminal.
Are you listening?
You think you were any better? You let him do whatever he wanted.
Thank you.
little bit too.
I don't know.
Your dad. Do you remember the day he drove by to get his things? It was a few weeks after you moved out. Temporarily, he said. It was February day when your dad came by for going in. You hauled your car driver. The day was suddenly here. I told you not to come outside, but you saw that truck and you smiled so wide. A real live truck in your driveway. We let you sit behind the wheel. Goodbye.
Space.
graduate soon, right?
In 2 weeks.
Wow. How's being a senior?
Busy.
I remember that.
How's being a freshman?
Oh, well, I actually decided to take a year off.
Oh.
Yeah. Try to save some money, get a job. I'll be taking classes at the community college, so I'll have some credits for transfer in the fall.
That's smart.
Yeah, we'll see. In the meantime, though, I can get you a friends and family discount at Pottery Barn. If you're looking for overpriced home decor.
You know, not at the moment.
Well, if you change your mind, I'm only working there for a few more months, though, so the window of opportunity is closing fast.
I always imagined you and Connor here, even though.
This is my first time. I mean, I've probably driven by it 1,000 times, but just every time I think about getting out of the car, I feel like I don't know, just like I don't deserve to, I guess. It's nice, peaceful.
My parents, they're here all the time. We do picnics like every weekend. It's helped a lot, actually, having this.
Have you ever told anyone? About Connors. About the note. About who really wrote it. They didn't have to do that. They could have told everyone. No, they did.
Everybody needed it for something.
That doesn't mean it was okay.
Saved my parents.
It's weird. Over the fall, I found this yearbook thing. My classmate in 8th grade. Most people did like collages of their friends. Connor was a list of his 10 favorite books. I've been trying to read all of them. I know it's not the same thing as knowing him. It is not at all. I don't know, it's...
Something... It's been hard. It's been a hard year.
I know. I've been wanting to call you for a really long time. I didn't really know what I would say. But I just decided to call anyway.
I'm happy you did.
I wish we could have met now. Today. For the first time.
Me too. I should probably.
No, totally.
It's just exams for this week.
Of course. Can I just ask you more? Why did you want to meet here?
I wanted to be sure you saw this.
Dear Evan Hansen, today is going to be a good day, and here's why. Because today, no matter what else, today at least, you're you. No hiding, no lying, just you. And that's enough. Hopeless, like everything is telling him to let go. This time, maybe this time he won't let go. He'll just hold on. He'll keep going. He'll keep going until he sees the sun.